Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to the first video in a small series that I want to record about this new project that is being developed as of the recording of this video in July 2024, that is called the BeeGraphy platform. And it's a project that I'm actually quite excited about for the reasons that I would like to show you along these videos. But what is BeeGraphy first? So BeeGraphy is this project that is basically an online computational design platform. What does that mean? It is, on one hand, it is an online editor for parametric modeling. So think of it as Grasshopper, but purely web-based. So everything that you do it with your browser. You don't have to install anything, download anything, blah, blah, blah. But then it's not just that. It's a platform because it allows other things to connect to this editor. And one of the features, for example, that I'm more excited about these days is the market. The market is basically this tool that allows you to take a definition or a model that you have created in the online editor, and then basically create this very simple UI that allows anyone to use that model without actually accessing all the components and the definition, et cetera, et cetera. So it's basically like a one-click sort of publish your definition and make it accessible and usable to a larger, perhaps not expert community. So I think it's a really nice tool. I've been playing around with it for a few weeks now. It has the online modeler, it has the marketplace to make models accessible to everyone for 3D printing, for rendering, etc. It has the API, which basically will allow people to integrate this functionality in other apps. The API is very heavily under development and as of the recording of this video. And right now, also, there's a competition going on, actually. So what I would like to do in these videos is I would like to give you like a crash course or like a really, really quick introduction into what BeeGraphy can do. Okay, so I'm going to then move on to the next video in this series where I'm going to start showing you the capacities of the editor. And the way I'm going to do this is by very quickly explaining how it works and then going on, moving on right away to hands-on examples. All right. If you want to learn more about BeeGraphy, just go to BeeGraphy.com. And if you are interested in this series, this video is going to be the first video of a playlist. So you can there's probably a link to the full playlist here in the description of this video, and otherwise there's probably a link to the playlist that is going to be popping up somewhere in the corner of this video as we speak right now. Okay, beautiful. So without further ado, and also friendly reminder, this is July 2024. If you're watching this from the distant future, then maybe BeeGraphy is already taking over the world and these videos are super redundant, but maybe you can just watch them as a historical kind of moment where BeeGraphy took over, you know? Anyway, I think I'm digressing here. So let's move on to the next video where I'm going to show you the basics of the BeeGraphy editor. See you in the next video. Bye.